Hello friends, welcome to Friend of Health. Welcome to the Competitor. In this video, we will try to see how to study Borix Materia Medica for All India Ayush Postgraduate Entrance Test 2020. For this, we will be seeing 7 questions which were asked from Borix Materia Medica in the 2019 All India Ayush Postgraduate Entrance Test. We will see one by one and from which areas of Borix these questions are framed, and through these questions we will try to learn how to read Borix Materia Medica. So the first question. A severely anemic patient complains of paralysis of extensors of forearm and progressive emaciation. Patient has a fear of being assassinated. There is a distinct blue line observed along the margin of gum with obstinate constipation and abdominal colic. Which is the most suitable remedy? So the options were alumina, plumbamet, platina and arginamet. So if you see the case, or if you see this question, it is framed in such a way that it is like a case. A case is presenting in front of you. So if you see each symptom, a severely anemic patient, paralysis of extensors of forearm, progressive emaciation, fear of being assassinated, distinct blue line observed along the margin of gum with obstinate constipation and abdominal colic. So these many informations are there in the question. So if a student knows all these points, he may be able to answer very fast. Even some of the points, some of the key points, if he knows, he can answer it very easily. But for confusing those students who have just read superficially, they have framed it with different questions, I mean different symptoms. So we need to be careful while reading Borix Materia Medica so that we can answer if they ask in any ways. So we will see the answer of this question. So this question's answer is plumbum metallicum. And you see from where and all these symptoms were picked. Pale and cachectic. There is a sentence that severely anemic patient. So we can see that the patient, plumbum metallicum patient, will be having a face with pale and cachectic features. And leg paralysis is chiefly of extensors of forearm or upper limb. There is one sentence in the introductory part of plumbum metallicum. And excessive and rapid emaciation. Fear of being assassinated. This was one of the point which many could answer that question just by knowing only single line. Sometimes it will be easy like this, like knowing a single line from the medicine will be helping us to answer the question. But many a times there will be confusing symptoms also. So while preparing for a competitive examination, to answer this type of questions, you need to be thorough with the picture of the remedy. Even there were points like distinct blue lines along margins of gums. So if one student is applying his FMT knowledge, forensic medicine knowledge, distinct blue lines along margins of gums, he may be able to answer plumbum metallicum. So obstructed flatus with intense colic. There was one symptom like obstinate constipation. So these were the symptoms picked for framing that question. So we can expect questions like this. So such questions, how to tackle is, while you read the Allen's keynote, those remedies you must read from Borix also, and add some certain peculiar and characteristic sensations like fear of being assassinated, all those peculiar symptoms and features of those drugs which are missing, which symptoms are missing in Allen's keynote, you may add from Borix. Or you may add those symptoms from Allen's keynote to Borix. So whichever Materia Medica you will be revising, mostly the students will be prepared, those students who are preparing for competitive examinations in homeopathy will be preparing Allen's keynote in a major share of time. So it's always better to add these symptoms, those peculiar symptoms from the introductory part or from the sensations or the main features of the drug which are missing in the Allen's keynote from Borix. To the drug in Allen's keynote textbook. So that is one method. And we'll move on to next question, which was asked in the 2019 AAPGT. Second question. which is the most suitable remedy for profuse watering from eyes after extraction of cinders and other foreign bodies. Options were Aconitum napillus, sulfuric acid, Ledum pal and Crotalus horridus. So this is a peculiar sensation which we cannot find in Allen's keynote. So this is a boric question. We have to identify that first. And for understanding this, like I told earlier, whenever you read a medicine from Allen's keynote, you need to add this kind of peculiar sensations or peculiar symptoms or characteristic features of those remedies from boric which are missing in Allen's keynote to the Allen's keynote. So this is such a type of question. So answer is Aconitum napillus. And if you see the eyes, you can see profuse watering after exposure to dry cold winds, reflection from snow, after extraction of cinders and other foreign bodies. So some types of some words, like peculiar words which are unique to some remedy which will not be found in other remedy, those are the areas of interest to frame questions for the question setters. So whenever you read boric, you have to identify such words and pick that symptoms and write down in your Allen's keynote. We'll move on to third question. According to William Boric, this remedy can be given when pulsatilla fail in schoolgirls. So options were calcarea fos, natrum mur, calicarb, calcarea carb. Options are slightly confusing because we can see schoolgirls, that keyword schoolgirls or schoolgirls complaints in most of the remedies. So this question's answer we can find in a relationship part of the remedy. So if you see here, when pulsatilla failed in schoolgirls, you can see on the screen. So that is relationship part of some remedy. So it is calcarea carb. The answer is calcarea carb. So the relationship part is very important while reading Boric's Materia Medica for competitive examinations, because you can see the relationship part will have certain peculiar symptoms or peculiar sayings by the masters. So if you see the relationship part of remedies, there will be some interesting lines. Those interesting lines will be favorite for those who are preparing questions. So if you see the relationship part of calcarea carb again, there is a symptom like porigo capitis, or a diagnosis porigo capitis, and the remedy for porigo capitis is calcarea mur or calcium chloratum. And this was asked in the UPSC 2016 Medical Officer Homeopathy. So this is the way questions are set from Boric's Materia Medica relationship part. We'll move on to another question. Question number 4. Sleeps with one leg drawn up and the other stretched out. This position of sleep is seen in which remedy? This is a straight question which looks like it's from Allen's keynote, but it is from Boric. So as I told earlier, whenever you read a Allen's keynote remedy, you try to read from Boric also and add such very peculiar symptoms from Boric to the Allen's keynote. So the options were rhododendron, platina, stanum met and pulsatilla. Answer is there in the sleep part of a remedy. Sleeps with one leg drawn up, the other stretched out. So this symptom we can see in stanum metallicum. Next question. Which remedy is most suitable for complaints from straining, especially flexor tendons? Options were Restox, Bellisperinis, Ruta and Arnica. All the options are very confusing. You cannot just write by wild guessing also, because all are very close running. All these remedies are having action on muscles and tendons. So without reading properly and making notes, you cannot answer this question. So this question was from Ruta Graviolens, and the question is picked or framed from the introductory part, complaints from straining flexor tendons especially. So introductory part of a drug is very important whenever you read Boric's Materia Medica. So Boric's Materia Medica questions will be framed from introductory part, peculiar sensations, relationship and sometimes modalities also. So we'll summarize it again. So before that, we'll see two more questions. Absence of pain and muscular mobility, especially in muscles of expression and of locomotion, is an indicator of. So the question is, Again, a peculiar thing, a peculiar interesting line, absence of pain and muscular mobility, especially in muscles of expression and of locomotion, is an indicator of. So options were opium, stramonium, lacanum and belladonna. So if you don't know, if you have not read properly with notes, you cannot answer this question. So the answer was stramonium, and it is taken from again the introductory part. Absence of pain, muscular mobility, especially of muscles of expression and of locomotion, stramonium. So introductory part, reading the introductory part, especially of the drugs which are given in Allen's keynote along with boric introductory part, is very very important. Otherwise also, many a times we can see questions with many a times we can see remedies which are not mentioned in Allen's keynote also came in competitive examinations from the boric's introductory part. Last question which was asked in 2019 AAPGT from boric was, the remedy for chronic complaints that date back to septic conditions is a Talandula cubensis, pyrogenium, alsalp and variolinum. So sometimes we can give a wild guess and write, but there are confusing options in this also, like variolinum and even alsalp we think about in septic conditions. So we'll see the answer. Pyrogen, answer is pyrogen, and it is again from the introductory part, chronic complaints that date back to septic conditions. So we'll summarize this, how to study Borax Materia Medica for competitive examinations in homeopathy, in points like important points from introductory part of each drug. So each drug, when you read from Allen's keynote, you have to make sure that you are reading the introductory part of boric about that remedy. Otherwise also, whenever you give time for Borax Materia Medica, read other remedies which are not there in Allen's keynote also, and go through the previous question papers where you can find many favorite questions which were repeated from this introductory part in UPSC especially and other MD entrance examinations. Next is symptoms given in italics. So sometimes questions will be directly from italics symptoms, which are very peculiar or very unique to that remedy. So those questions, those symptoms given in italic are very important in the examination point of view. And peculiar and characteristic sensations, this again sometimes which may not be given in italics, but it will be very peculiar, very unique. Well, while reading itself, it will be very interesting. So that also you have to make sure that you are going through that and making notes of that. And important points in modalities and relationship sections, this is also very important, because many a times questions have come from modalities part and relationship part in UPSC and MD entrance examinations. Also we have seen in AAPGT especially. So all the best wishes for All India Ayush Postgraduate Entrance Test Homeopathy aspirants 2020, and we will be there for supporting you with valuable informations like this. We look forward to see your valuable comments and feedbacks about the video. Please subscribe our channel and share with your friends who are preparing for entrance examination this year. Once again, thank you. Best wishes.